Welcome to class 4, subject English grammar. Today's topic is prepositions. Let us begin. Mom, why are we in the car?
We are going to visit Aunt Meena.
I meant, why aren't we on a bus?
Because this is faster.
Now you can see here there are some bold letters. Okay, the letters which are darker. In, on, to, okay. So these are called as the prepositions. Okay. So first we will understand what is a preposition. A preposition is a word which shows the relationship between a noun or a pronoun and some other word in a sentence. Okay. So it is showing us a relationship between the noun or a pronoun. Prepositions can be of different types. Let us look at three different types of prepositions. First one, prepositions of place. Second, prepositions of time. Third, prepositions of movement or direction. First one, prepositions of place. Prepositions of place show where the nouns or pronouns are. Okay, where is a noun present, whether it is near or far, okay, in which place it is present, okay, that is called as preposition of place. There, the preposition of place are in, on, at, inside, under, between, near, above, etc. Now look at this picture here. Now can you make out where is the spoon? Okay, the spoon is in the glass. The spoon is in the glass. So what is telling us, which word is telling us here that where is the spoon? It is in. In is the word which is telling us where is the spoon. Okay, so in is the preposition used here. Several birds are sitting on the branch. Can you see here? The birds are sitting. Where are they sitting? They are sitting on the branch. So, on is the preposition used here. The fan is above our heads. So, where is the fan? It is above. Above is the preposition. The papers were inside the briefcase. So, here inside is the preposition. Okay. Next, prepositions of time. Prepositions of time are used in the context of time, day, month, year, etc. They are in, on, at, before, after, till, until, etc. She will be downstairs in 5 minutes. Okay. So, when we are telling about the preposition of time, we have to use the prepositions like in, on, and at, depending upon what we are using. Okay. Like if we are telling about the time here, in minutes, in whether she is coming in how much time, we are using the word in. Ruchi will come home on Friday. Okay, that is in future we are using Friday. So, we are using the preposition on. The postman will come at 12:30 p.m. Here we are using again for the time at. Prepositions of movement or direction. These prepositions are used when the nouns or pronouns are moving. They are to, into, through, across, along, towards, around, etc. For example, we are walking to the bakery. Okay, we are walking to the bakery. That means what? You are going to the bakery. So, we are walking to the bakery. Preposition is to. The frogs are jumping into the water. That means the action is going on. Okay. That is the moving action. We are using the word here into. The moon revolves around the earth. Okay. So preposition here is around for the movement or the direction of something. Fill in the blanks with appropriate prepositions. They have gone dash the market. What is the preposition you will use here? They have gone to the market. She was dash home when I called. She was at
home when I called. In the same way, use the correct prepositions. Then next, fill in the blanks with in, at, or in. We have a library period dash 10 a.m. That is at 10 a.m. Here we are using preposition of time. Okay. The train will reach Delhi in 12 hours. Then next here, choose words from the box and fill in the blanks. The swimmer is diving dash the pool. The swimmer is diving into the pool. So here we are using preposition of movement and direction. Okay. Prepositional verbs. Prepositional verbs are verbs and prepositions that are often used together. They may have a different meaning when used together. Example, believe in, look after, take after, talk about, wait for. So we are using here two words with different meanings. Okay. When used in a sentence, the two words are always placed together. They cannot be separated. They are also always followed by an object. For example, my parents believe in me. Okay, they are used together and the sentence will not be completed unless we use both of them together. My parents believe in me. I will look after my parents when I am older. So here, prepositional verbs are my parents. Okay, Seema's children take after her. Seema's children take after her. Then here, choose the words from the box and fill in the blanks. Okay. So you have to fill in the blanks and use the words accordingly. Okay. This activity has to be done by you. Discuss with your partners and write a few sentences describing his route. Use the words given in the box. So by using these words, you have to complete this. Choose the correct options and fill in the blanks. So accordingly, you have to use the correct prepositions and fill in the blanks. Here also, exercise G. Choose the correct options and fill in the blanks. Okay, it is the same. Even exercise H also is the same.